Hi, so we're looking at CAT 2020 DLR slot 3 set 2. So high low game. So this is the data, this is the questions given to you. Try to solve on your own before you look at the solution. So in this particular data, you need to first get the solution and then maybe you can look at the questions as such. The high low game has 4 player, 6 rounds. Every round each player chooses a bid high or low. The bids are made simultaneously. If all the four bid are high, then all four lose 1 point. So I'll just write it down. If all four are high, then everyone gets -1 points. Okay. If three high, one low, then players bidding high gets 1 point each. So three high gets 1 point each, and the one low gets -3. Two players bid high and two low, then the players bidding high gain 2 points each. Okay. And players bidding low lose 2 points. If one player bids high and three low, then a player bidding high gains 3 points. So one player high and three low -3 and three low players +1. Sorry, this one gains 3 points and this one loses 1 point. Right? They say low loses 1 point each and gains 3 points. If all four bid low, then all four gain 1 point each. Then four players are given and they're given following facts. So there are A, B, C, D and the points are given. So let's write that down. A, B, C and D. So we know that in third round, Arun has scored 6 points. Deepak has scored 2 points. And B and C has scored -2, -2. Sixth round, if I look at it, Arun has scored 7 points. B and C has scored -1 and -1 each. B and D, sorry. And C has scored -5. Right. This is how it is. Points are given. Deepak's score in the third round was less than his score in the first round. So Deepak's score in the third round was less than his score in the first round, but more than his score in the second round. In exactly two of the four rounds, Arun has scored, was the only player who scored high. So Arun high in exactly two rounds. Okay, only high. This is the only data we have. So where do we start? Now if you notice, every time the net score is zero for these three cases. Okay, if you look at three highs, one low, total score is zero for all the four players. Two highs, two lows, total score is zero for all the four players. One high, three lows, total score is zero for all the three players. Because one gets +3, three gets -1, total zero. Out here, the total becomes -4 because all the four gets -1. Out here, total becomes +4. And remaining is 0, as I said, 0, 0, 0. So, why is it important? Because if you look at third round, he has got a net score of +4. Why will he get net score of +4? Because in one of the rounds, all the four have scored low, for sure. In one of the three rounds, all of them have scored low. If all of them have scored low, then all of them have got +1 point. Right? All the four have got +1 point. Now, if Arun has got +1, for example, in one of the rounds, so rest two rounds he has to get 5 points. How will he get 5 points? In the first three rounds, if one of the rounds he has scored all four lows +1, he has to get 5 points. The only way he can get 5 points is if he scores +3 and +2. That means in the first three rounds, Arun has scored +3 in one round, +2 in one round, and +1 in the last round. So last these three cases in the first three rounds. How do I know what case is what? We can take the hint of Deepak. So Deepak must have went all the four must have scored +1. Deepak also must have scored +1. So Deepak has got +1 for sure in one of the rounds. The combination of the other two rounds should be +1 because total score is 2. How can it be +1 for Deepak for remaining two? Which is possible if he gets +2 and -1. So that means he has got +1 in round 3, he must have got +2 in round 1, and he must have got -1 in round 2. Right? +1 in round 3, that's and he's got lesser points than +2 in round 1 and +1 in round 4. So if he has got +2 in round 1, that means he must have scored high. Arun also must have scored high, but Arun got +2, and the rest two must have scored low. If he has got plus 3 in round 3, that means all the 4 must have scored low in the round 3. So which means he scored plus 2 in, sorry, minus 1 in round 2, which is where Arun must have scored high and all the 3 must have scored low. That's how you get. So this is the first 3. That's what they are given. Now coming to remaining 3. Now they have not given for remaining 3 what is what. But can I find a breakup of scores? So let's try it out. Now I know in one of the rounds Arun has scored high, only person who scored high. So that is one of the 3 rounds. So he has scored high and the rest 3 have scored low. Which means he has got plus 3 out here. Which become 9. Now to go to 7, he has to lose 2 marks. Also its total score out here is 0. If you look at 7 minus 1 minus 5 minus 1 is 0. How will total score come to 0? From plus 4 it has come to 0. Which means one round all the 4 have scored high for sure. In one of the rounds all the 4 have scored high for sure. So the net net becomes minus 4. So here Arun will lose 1 point. So 6 plus 3 9, 9 minus 1 8. So in the last round also he must have lost 1 point. Okay, let's look at for others. So if you look at B would lose 1 point out here. Here he's got high, so he'll lose again 1 point out here. So minus 4. To get to plus 1, he should score plus 3. And the only way he can score plus 3 is when the others 2 have scored, all others have scored minus 1. So he has got high and others have got low. And this, if you look at, satisfies for everyone. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So we get the whole trick. So idea is to get at his total. Once you notice total is plus 4 out here and 0 out here, you know in one of the rounds all of them have scored high. Use that. Also we know one of the rounds Arun has scored high and else have, all else has scored low. Once you quote the points for two of them, you can get the points for third. Now using this we can get the answer. Now if you look at what were the bids of Arun A, B, C, D especially in first round, which he got high, low, low, high, which is C option. How many rounds did Arun bid high? If you look at properly, Arun bid high in 4 of the rounds. So 4. How many rounds did B bid low? B bid low in first 4 rounds. I mean first 3 rounds and one more round. 4. How many rounds did all 4 players made identical bids? 2. One bid all 4 lows, one bid all 4 highs. And how many rounds did Deepak gain exactly 1 point? So Deepak must have got plus 1 is in the third round. That's the only way he got plus 1. Yes, so that means the answer is 1. In which of the following rounds did Arun definitely the only player who bid high? So we know that in the second round he is definitely the player to bid high. So we know A option. So with that we get all the answers. So once you get the whole table and the understanding, you get the complete answer easily. Right? Thank you.